Morning to all. I am Dr. Jayashila, Assistant Professor of Commerce, Government First Grade College, Aurad, District Bidar. Today in this video, I am going to discuss about dissolution of the firm. This is for BCom second semester students. So here, in this chapter, mainly we must know about the partners. Here, partner is a person, and partners means the number of persons, means two or more persons. What is a partnership means? The partnership is the relations between persons who have agreed to share the profit or losses of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. So here all the partners are acting in the business or involved in the business, or any one or two are acting in the business, or one or two are rest in the business activities. So here the person who have entered into the partnership with one another are called as a individually partners and collectively a firms. Here dissolution of the firm means, the dissolution of firm means the termination of connection with the business by all the partners, and the firm comes to end. So here dissolution of the firm means all the partners are agreed to close their business activities. So that is a dissolution of the firms, means the business activities are closing up or winding up. So here what is the dissolution of the partnership means? Dissolution of the partnership means the termination of connection with the firms by some partners of the firm, and remaining partners of such firms continue the business under the same firm. So here dissolution of the firm means all the partners are ready to close their business, ready to close the business. That is a dissolution of the firms. Dissolution of the partner means the any one or two persons or one or two partners are ready to close business, means they are come out from the business activities. So that is a dissolution of the partnership. Here what are the differences between the dissolution of the partnership firm or dissolution of the partner? So here in case of dissolution of the partnership firm, all the partners are ready, or all the partners are agree to close the business activities. Dissolution of the partner means one or two partners, they are closing or they are ready to close the business. So here dissolution of the firm means the business is ending, and the dissolution of the partnership means the person is no more in relation with the company or business. So here dissolution agreement is very important in this chapter. So here the business or any company starting with the agreement and ending it is also with the agreement. So here partnership firm is always formed or started by the agreement between the partners, and it can also close the agreement between the partners. So here if the firm is dissolved with the consent of all the partners, it is said to be a dissolution by the agreement. So here in certain circumstances firm is dissolved. What are those circumstances? Certain situations the firm or business is completely closing down or winding up. So when a partner becomes a permanently incapable, what situation? The first situation, here the partner becomes completely incapable of performing his duties as a partner. The person is a partner. If he is not able to perform his duty properly, then he must be dissolved. So it is one of the situation. Then another one is, partner is guilty of misconduct, and it is like of effect of the business. Sometimes business activities going under the loss situation. On that situation, the partner is totally disappointed. Disappointing that situation, he is not able to run the business. So that circumstances is also cause of dissolution of the firm. So here, when a partner is willfully, sometimes what happen, he is willingly, he don't want to run the business, or he don't want to involved in the business activities. Personally, he ready to close down his business activities. So that time also, that circumstances is also cause of the dissolution of the firm. So here, what is a compulsory dissolution? Here the partners are their own agreely, sometimes they are dissolving the firms. But here compulsory dissolution means what? Here compulsory dissolution means all the partners sometimes insolvent. All the partners are insolvent, or one partner is solvent, or rest of the all the partners are insolvent. On that situation, the firm must be closed. Then second situation means, here in the one person, the all the partners are death. On the death of the all the partners, are all the partner except one partner is died. Here that situation also one of the cause of dissolution of the firms. And on the conduct of business becomes illegally. Sometimes what happened in the business area, some of the businessmen, they are illegally conducting the or running the business. On that time, court is ordered to close their business. According to the court order, he must be or they must be close their business activities. These are the causes for dissolution of the firm. First, number one is the partners are insolvent, or second, death of the partner, and third one, illegal activities. Sometimes the business is under the illegal activity, that time also it is for the cause of dissolution of the firms. So here, in the dissolution of the firms, the order of payment is how they order the payment of their shareholders, creditors, or other outsiders. The payment of payments on dissolution of the firms. So here, in the dissolution of the firms, they have to pay first outside liabilities. Outside liabilities means debenture holders, creditors, or bank overdraft. Bank, if they are taken the loan from the bank, they must pay first loan to the that bank holders. So here outside liability, they must clear the outside liability. Secondly, the compulsory, they have to be pay the loan of the partners. The loan of the partners. So that is in a second payment under the dissolution of the firms. And thirdly, among the partners, according to their profit and loss ratio, their profit sharing ratio, the amount should be distributed among all the partners. So this is the payment of the dissolution of the firms. In this chapter, the mainly we can prepare the three types of accounts, three accounts. One is the realization account, and another one is the partners capital account. Third one is the cash or bank account. In the realization account, it means it is opened at the time of dissolution. Realization account yavaga open martivanta at the time of dissolution of the firm. Yak martivandre, why means here to know the profit or losses on realization of assets and payment of liabilities and expenses. So here the realization account is very important and prime account in the dissolution of the firms, because in this account it shows the what are the profit or losses realization of assets and payment of liabilities and other expenses. So in this here, partnership account means the partners, before knowing the partnership account, here partners, two kinds of partners we know here. One is a solvent partner, another one is a insolvent partner. Solvent partner means he is ready to pay the liabilities of the business, means his credit balance is more than the debit balance. So he is ready to pay the business. That person we call as a solvent partners or actively engaged partner. Or insolvent partner means the partner in insolvent is his capital account shows the debit balance is more than the credit balance, means he is unable to bring the cash from his private estate to make the good his good in his capital deficiency. Means here insolvent partner means the person he is not liable for pay the tax, not able to pay the liabilities of the business. So that person we call as a insolvent partner. In the dissolution of the firms, here Garner versus Murray case is very important. According to that case only we solve the certain problem. The in this case the following rules are they must be followed. What are their rules? Each solvent partner should bring in cash to the extent of his share of realization loss. Here all the partners should bring their capital or cash in the business to extent his share of realization losses. And another rule, what it is said means the net deficit capital of insolvent partner should be borne by the solvent partner. Here insolvent capital of the insolvent partner's capital is borne by the solvent partners in their capital sharing ratio. Thus then here what is how the application of this, when the application of the this Garner versus Murray case, in this case there must be at least one insolvent partner and at least two solvent partners. Here one is an insolvent partner and two are the solvent partner. That time we must apply the Garner versus Murray rules. Then another situation is when the for calculation of capital ratio, here only solvent partners having the credit balance should be considered. If the partner is solvent but his balance is debit balance in the capital account, that partner is not considered in the calculation of the capital ratio. Only solvent partners can calculate the ratio. And lastly, I want to discuss about the this chapter. There are three accounts we must create in this chapter. One is a realization account, one is a partner's capital account and cash account. Thank you. In the next video I discuss about the 5 marks questions about dissolution of the firm. Thank you.